Well, did you know that this year marks the 40th anniversary of the glossy primetime TV drama Dynasty? Well, it is. I've done the maths. The splashy series will forever be remembered as the ultimate 80s super soap. And, along with Joan Collins, Dynasty turned the beautiful Linda Evans into one of TV's brightest and shiniest stars. Recently, I had the great joy of chatting with Linda, zooming into her home in Washington State. She is gracious, stunning, and thoroughly divine. Beat, but still my beating heart, take a look. The stunning Linda Evans has been a much-loved star of stage and screen for over half a century. From her breakout role in the 60s as Audra Barclay on the hit TV western The Big Valley, to finding superstardom amid the crazy catfights, the endless drama, the big hair and huge shoulder pads on the 80s primetime ratings juggernaut, Dynasty.
I'm not a child, Matthew. I'm a grown woman. I have the God-given right to make my own decisions.
I understand that.
No, you don't understand.
Yet despite her enormous success, the classy star says a career in showbiz wasn't planned and that she originally fell into acting by accident.
In junior high school, I wouldn't get up and give a book report. So my teacher said to my mother, I think she needs to take drama because she needs to overcome her shyness. Well, I hated the whole idea. However, when I was 15, a girlfriend took me on an interview. She was up for a commercial. And she asked me just to come with her. And the director came out and he said, I'll see you. I said, oh, no, I'm just here. She said, go in and just say hi. So I walked in and he was very nice. And he said, I want you to do my commercial. I said, well, I'm not going to do your commercial. I said, I wouldn't do that to my girlfriend. He said, I promise you, if you do it, I will give her another commercial.
Wow.
I did the commercial. He was wonderful. He gave my girlfriend a commercial. He gave me two more after that, and that began a reluctant career.
Linda's first TV series speaking role was in an episode of Bachelor Father, which starred John Forsythe, who, decades later, would play her oil tycoon hubby Blake on Dynasty.
Who would have guessed, right? I was only 15.
Welcome to Soggy Pie.
And what was so sweet was I met John again, and this was 1980, and he walked on the set and he said, my little Linda Evanstead, how you've grown, and how is your mother, Arlene? I thought, oh my God, he remembers my mother, her name. I said, John, it's gonna be so easy to love you in the show.
This is Barclay Land and I'm Audra Barclay.
You went on to star in a wonderful series of the 60s, The Big Valley, working with one of the absolute greats in Hollywood, Linda, and we're talking Barbara Stanwyck. What was that experience like?
Well, it was amazing to be working with a living legend, and I was 23 years old. I was blown away by my opportunities.
Were you a little nervous thinking, my gosh, I mean, just how do you play with somebody like that?
I was terrified. I thought, oh my gosh, she has such a presence and she's just huge. And she walked on the set and she was smaller than me, but she's shorter. But do not mistake her height for her energy and who she is.
No one, not Railroad, nor Jordan, nor Thomas Barclay can own.
After the death of Linda's mum, Arlene, the great Barbara Stanwyck stepped in and became Linda's protector, her mentor and showbiz mum, and the two enjoyed decades of close friendship.
Mom passed away while I was doing the show, and one day she put her arm around me. She said, I will never replace your mom, but I'll be your mom now. And she was there for me for the rest of her life.
Do you like your job, Joseph?
I believe I can always get another one.
Could you?
In 1980, along comes the splashy role of a lifetime. The character was Crystal Carrington, and the show, the now iconic Dynasty. When you read that first script, what were your initial thoughts?
I knew it was going to be a magical show to do. When my agent sent it to me and I sat down, by the time I finished it, I said, I hope they choose me because I loved it.
I understand that, but I would still like to know how much.
We were opposite MASH in its final years, so it was a hard first couple of years because, of course, America was in love with MASH.
Oh, you miserable b***h.
There is that moment where you shove Joan Collins as Alexis into the lily pond. Did you really sail into that water, Linda?
We didn't sail into the water because it was so shallow. It was only about 4 feet deep, and that would have been very dangerous for us to throw each other in. But we were definitely in fighting each other on our hands and knees, unfortunately, because it was so shallow. And there were mistakes where you didn't mean to hit each other in the way you did because you were just sort of flailing around. Of course, apologies came, but I never bruised her or did anything like that to her.
No one gave you permission to come into this house.
I don't need permission, Crystal.
Joan Collins, of course, you'd known prior to the show and she'd been to your home for dinner and so forth. Was she a little like her Alexis character when you boil it down?
Not really. Joan, and most people don't know this side of her, is a devoted mother. I mean, she's very nurturing. She's an excellent actress. And so everyone was convinced that she was Alexis.
Providing that not one word of this leaks out to anybody. Not your company, not Andrew Laird, not even your lovely wife, number two.
I'd like to remind you that Crystal is number one.
How could I forget?
Now, before the break, Linda Evans was reminiscing about her stellar career and her time on the 80s super soap Dynasty, but her life hasn't always been smooth sailing. My super candid chat with the ever-gorgeous Linda continues from her home in Washington State as we look back at her amazing showbiz life and also some of those painful personal moments.
Oh, you do protest. What did I do, Alexis?
Linda, that show, as you know, was enormous. What was that level of fame like?
I was in Italy and I was having an argument with my boyfriend at dinner, and then you look around, there's just all these people just watching you, and you want to cry and you can't and you don't know what to do, and you're very grateful that it is that successful. But that's why I eventually left, because I wanted a life.
And who knows? I may even invite you and Blake if the whim strikes me.
Save your whims, Alexis. He won't be coming.
What was the real Aaron Spelling like to work with?
He was wonderful. He said to me, okay, you ever have a problem, you come and see me. Just pick up the phone. And I only picked up the phone like two times in 10 years. And in 6 minutes, I was sitting opposite him, explaining to him what I wanted him to understand. And he would think about it. He was very fair. We'd discuss it. He'd say, okay, we're going to do that.
Haji, 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 Baba, Haji, Baba.
One of the great loves of Linda's life was the legendary actor-director John Derrick, who, as it turns out, captured the heart of the star-struck young actress years before they met.
I was just a teenager and I saw Haji Baba, put it over my bed, and I said to my sister, I'm going to marry him. And she went, yeah, sure, you're going to marry him.
You and John Derrick seem such a picture of bliss, and you've written about the fact that Bo Derrick came into the equation, which for you was such a jolt. How eventually, Linda, with, I guess, the fabulousness of hindsight, did you put your life back together?
It happens in stages. I think in the beginning, there's a righteous feeling of rage that happens, and then there's a tremendous grief. I may have gone on with my life and got married and whatever, but I never, ever stopped loving him. I just changed my perspective of how I would love him.
Linda's life may have seemed like a magic carpet ride of fame and fortune, but behind the fabulous facade, she'd been left reeling by a series of crushing heartaches and devastating health problems, including crippling back pain, plunging her into a depression so severe she even contemplated ending it all. How did you see your way out of those awful situations?
Someone very wise said to me, learn from the pain. Don't run away from the pain, learn from it. I tried really, really, really hard to fix it through natural therapies, acupuncture and water therapy and physical therapy. And after a couple of years, it didn't work and it got so bad, that's when I started going into depression. It was just a never-ending sense of the hole I couldn't get out of. I'm, however, very grateful that I went through that, because I have been one of the healthiest, strongest people that I know. My body is like a tank. Not being that way for 2.5 years gave me so much compassion for people. It helped me to understand humanity better than I ever could have.
She signed the adoption papers this morning. She put them in the mail. We'll get them in a couple of days.
Or is that all? I thought it was something really important.
Is there any chance somebody might call you up and say, Linda Evans, I've got the role of a lifetime, and you might say yes?
It's so outrageous to even think of going back to work at 78. But what I love that I talk to women about is never to discount anything, to be open-minded. I did do a tiny part in an indie film that may be coming out this year. I have another script they just sent me that I'm reading the second draft on. What I'm seeing in my life is if something comes to me and pulls me to it, then I can't say no.
And that's why we love you so much, because of your honesty, your candor.
You're very sweet. You're a lovely man, very lovely man.
You want me to finish shaving you first?
You're silly. After what I have in mind.